Hey y'all, sorry for the horrible audio and the horrible video. This is a quick video. My main camera is dead and I no longer own that. So I don't know what I'm going to do for videos from here on out, but I wanted to do this quick video. It's really important. A lot of people are asking me, what can they do? They're in a really bad heat wave and they either A, are being told to turn up the thermostat so make it warmer in the house, or B, they have no power at all. So this may be a little too late, but this may not. It may save some of you guys. So one thing I would recommend you do is you go to Lowe's, Home Depot, Walmart, something like that, and look and see if you can find a small BTU air conditioner. So like a half-ton cooling 5,000 BTU air conditioner. Install that in your bedroom, probably your master bedroom or somewhere where your family can fit comfortably. Now, you don't want to put it in a big space because it's not going to cool that good. It's made for a smaller space, like 400 to 600 square feet, especially if it's really hot outside. That's even going to reduce it down to, it might only be 250 square feet. But, you know, a bedroom you can make really nice and cold with one of these units. Next, get yourself a generator that can run that air conditioner. Verify that you can run that air conditioner. Read the specs on both the boxes and everything and verify that you can do it. And then buy yourself a generator. And then get some extension cords. Now, don't buy the cheap 16-gauge extension cords, you know, the ones you see at Lowe's or Home Depot or Walmart that are 100 foot long for 10 bucks. No, you need to buy at least a 12-2 extension cord. Better yet, a 10-2 extension cord. Now, install that little air conditioner and run it on the generator. This does two things. If obviously your power is out, well, now you got an air conditioner and you've got one cool, safe space to be in, you know, more or less. And also you can then run your refrigerator and that kind of thing, a few lights, little things like that. But also, if your power is on, but they're telling you to turn up your thermostat, that air conditioner can now supplement the big air conditioner in the house. And it's not on the grid, it's running on the generator. So you're not hurting the grid, you're helping, you know, you're reducing your power usage. But don't do this. Do not go and buy a window unit and then just plug it into the wall thinking you're helping the power usage. You're not. You're using more power at that space. But if you're running on a generator, a solar generator, whatever you have to run it on, then obviously you're not putting that extra load on the grid. I've done this before myself personally. Guys, I live in the South. I live in South Carolina. I live on the coast. We've gone through hurricanes, tornadoes, all kinds of stuff. Today it was not bad, but there's been 115 degree days with 99% humidity, and it doesn't cool off at night. You know, it'll get 80 degrees at night. We just had one of these recently, 80 degrees at night, and it's still 85 or 90% humidity. So I'm talking from experience. These are things I've done before. These things work. Just got to be careful with what you do. Hopefully those few tips can help you out. I will do my best to get a new camera. I don't have a lot of money, so it might take a while before I can come up with a new camera. But in the meantime, I am still here. If you guys have any questions, comments, concerns, please leave them below. Thanks a lot. Take care, and God bless.